self-disrespectful. Self-disrespectful.
Hi, YouTube.
What's up, people? So, Sunday, and we're here. And yesterday, we had looked at the video with Carmen Ortega, the one they posted of her doing her little tour of Reggie Bush's house. For people who don't know, it's I guess Reggie, that's supposed to be Reggie Bush's jump off when him and Kardashian were together, I guess, beforehand. So that made us come and start thinking about this video today that we're gonna do. So basically, year of the jump off. Like, jump off these days are out of control. What happened to the old jump off that used to just be, you know, in the back, you know, the background, not say nothing, knew her position, and just left it at that. Now the jump offs today, they mad because they getting wiped up, popping off, saving text messages and all this stuff, just to put you out on blast at one point in time. So we all know it really, I'm trying to think, when did the jump off start, like people getting out of control start? Probably, I think with the whole Tiger Woods incident, seemed like last year, like, he got out of control. All his jump offs came out the woodworks, talking about their different affairs and stuff like that. And then, now we see it traveling on to 2010 with her, and then we had there's this other lady, I don't know, but some socialites, I think on the East Coast, and where some lady was in a relationship, an affair with this dude who was married, I think, for like a long time, and she had an 8-year affair with him, and then got mad because he cut her off, so she wouldn't put billboards in all the cities that he lived about being the love of his life, even though he had a wife. So like I said, like, what is going on with jump offs?
I feel that you knew he had a girlfriend, you knew he was married. So it's your fault, pretty much. If you get to catch your feelings, you knew you were a jump off. You knew what you was getting yourself in. So I think you just have a seat. Stop popping up in the mouth after the fact when you don't want to catch feelings back on with you. You know, you're just a jump off. Like Cassie, she knows her place. She fits on. She knows her place.
No, it's just great. Like, that's exactly why. In my other video, I said married men are a no-no, freaking just a no-no. My thing is, if you're gonna get yourself into that position, then you can't complain. You already knew from jump what you was getting yourself into. So I mean, now that you made your bed, you gotta lay in it. You can't get mad just because he don't want to wipe you up and give you the credentials of being that special someone. You knew from the jump you was the jump off. So now that he won't even let you go, or things happen and things change, you become spiteful and want to put people out there and put videos out like a couple days before game day just to get people distracted and stuff, or put billboards out or make songs or freaking go to magazines and say I was a jump off. Who's fault? Your fault? Your fault for going to be in that position. Obviously your standards weren't high enough. And you settled for being a jump off. You can't be mad. You can't be mad. You can't be. Point blank period. You can't. And my thing is, people always try to come out and talk about, oh, black women are crazy. Now, if we see all these jump offs that have been coming out of the woodworks are not, well, except for that one lady with the 8-year thing, but they try to act like black women only act crazy. No. Freaking white women acting, and Hispanic, any other race could act just as crazy. Take your belt off and hang yourself. So I guess they women scorn, and they can't get mad to start people's life because you put yourself in that position. If you don't want to be in a position, get you a single man who's ready to be with you and give you all that.
And if you haven't watched the Married Man video that we did, it's in the inbox onto the left.
Besides that, just if you're a jump off, know your position. If you don't want to be a jump off, don't do it. And don't be spiteful just because you can't be wifey. Point blank.
You will never be wifey.
And
he sees, you know what? Because he really sees what type of woman you are. Yeah. You know, if you playing second, I mean.
No, that's, y'all go watch the video too, because that is funny. She really walking around this dude's house like first of all, that's Reggie Bush's stuff. That is not your stuff. You make yourself look extra stupid walking around like talking like it's your stuff. Like, oh, this is the life. Well, it ain't your life. It ain't your money. Like, you know. So, anyways, I hope y'all have a great Super Bowl Sunday. Hope you're watching the game. Oh, yeah, and also, what's the God? It's going to be a quick short video because I got to get ready for work. But, we will be going to Dallas for All-Star Weekend this Thursday. I'm trying to get some footage of our trip and stuff and post it up. Hopefully, you know, get some activities, hit some clips. Don't know how much video footage we'll actually get, but, you know, we'll try to get some for y'all. So, show y'all our fun time. But we out, and I'll let y'all
need me. See me, I'm number one. I'm loading up my gun. I catch you and you're done. You pussy nigga, run. Cross me. I'm so disrespectful. So disrespectful. See, I get so disrespectful. So disrespectful. When you cross me, I'm so disrespectful. So disrespectful. See, I get so disrespectful. So disrespectful.